see right here?
The chestnuts up there?
There are a lot of chestnuts here.
My sophomore year of high school, I took a class called woodworking, and part of the class was learning about the different trees, and my teacher had mentioned American chestnuts and how they're so rare and how they're so valuable. And so I had become intrigued after that and started researching them on my own time for a few years. So when I had finally met Glen Ray, I was very prepared and I tried to, you know, impress him with all my knowledge.
The American chestnut tree at one time, approximately 120 years ago, was the dominant hardwood tree in the East. About one out of every four hardwood trees was a chestnut tree. And then a blight came in.
The blight is a fungus that attacks the Native American chestnuts. It's endemic to Asia and especially China. We think it arrived on nursery stock imported in 1904 into New York. From there, it spread fairly rapidly and progressed all the way from the northern end of the range of the American chestnut to the southern range. Within 40, 50 years, it was functionally extinct.
So it was a great ecological disaster because the early settlers depended on it so much. It was the ideal tree for making log cabins. They didn't need a foundation. They could put it directly on the ground. It was highly rot resistant. Every year it produced a good crop, so the wildlife could survive off of it. So it was just almost a perfect tree.
The restoration effort involves back cross breeding to introduce genes that are resistant from the Chinese tree and yet still retain the characteristics that make the American chestnut unique.
And we purposely infected or inoculated the trees with a weaker strain and then a stronger strain at the bottom so that when it rains down on the tree, the stronger end won't spread but still at the bottom. And the idea is that they're going to get sick, but the ones that have the most resistance will be able to recover. So in 1 year's time, a lot of these trees are going to die. Most of them are going to die. And it seems kind of sad, but it's necessary to get the right genes that we want back into the program.
This right here is a Chinese chestnut,
and we put these in here as controls. You can see that the leaves are smaller.
It's a great opportunity for the undergraduate students to get involved with nonprofits like the American Chestnut Foundation. It gives them exposure to a nationwide effort to preserve a tree that's very iconic to this area. It's also a great opportunity to have some adventure and go mapping in areas that are, you know, unique and forested and far away. And for us, with the lab and our resources, having a team of people who are dedicated to ground pounding out in the field and ground truthing those sites where we're flying over, it's a real big plus and a lot of fun.
When the Chestnut Foundation came to us this past spring and asked us to do a survey flight for them, our goal for this past summer was to basically take GPS points of known chestnut locations throughout different areas of the state and see if we could photograph them from the air and find out if our cameras can identify chestnut trees more easily than just, you know, if someone were walking around through the forest. This is an image of one of the chestnut locations in Freiburg. This is with the infrared camera. And as you can see, chestnut flowers that are in bloom really stand out well compared to the other vegetation surrounding it. We also used the true color camera we recorded in stereo so that we can make 3D measurements of the trees too, which is kind of a neat capability. Not just finding their coordinates on the ground, but being able to tell the field crew how tall of a tree it is. It's pretty important. So our goal for next summer is going to be using data of suitable chestnut habitat and then fly those areas and see if we can find new trees, get their GPS positions so that we can send a field crew out and investigate from the ground.
There's no better way to have students involved than in outreach projects because it gives them an opportunity to make other contacts for future jobs possibility, but also it gives them a chance to see that there's things that happen outside the classroom that are important to their surroundings. So being involved in this chestnut project is great. Yesterday I was out in the field with a couple of the students who are actually involved in the project, and they just talk about it all the time. It's like the highlight of their life.
We got some viable seeds over here.
Yeah.
The young foresters coming out today are going to be working with chestnut trees. When I was in forestry school, we didn't even talk about chestnut tree. It was just sort of given that it's gone, you know. Why bother with it? It's nice to read about it in the history. But now we know it's going to work, and now we need to get it out. So this is where the young foresters, that these students coming along now they're going to carry the ball for us, in effect.
If you're interested in restoring the culture, and you're interested in restoring the economy, and if you're interested in restoring balance to nature when it comes to, you know, supplying all that food that the wildlife were once accustomed to, then that would be an important reason why people of my generation would want to become involved with the chestnut. That's why it's relevant.